So good morning students. In the continuing chapter of general organic chemistry, yesterday I discussed that how this term organic is being originated, how the different compounds that are known at that time were being classified into two categories, organic and inorganic, on the basis of source from which they are obtained, and how vital force theory was being discarded by the work of Frederick Wöhler. Today, we know that organic chemistry is the branch of chemistry that deals with the study of carbon and its compounds in the simplest form. Although, if we go by the complicated definition, then we say that it is a branch of chemistry that deals with the study of hydrocarbons and their derivatives. But in a more simplified form, we say that branch of chemistry that deals with the study of carbon and its compounds, excluding carbonates, carbides, is called organic chemistry. Now, there are almost more than hundreds of elements present in periodic table, and only one element is studied in one separate branch, and rest all other elements are studied in a different branch. So what is so specific with that for carbon we need a different branch? For only one element, carbon, we have a separate branch of chemistry which is called organic chemistry. For remaining 114 elements, we have another branch in which all other elements, their compounds, they all are studied. And that branch is called as inorganic chemistry. So simple answer to this question is that total number of carbon compounds are very high. It's huge. Millions of organic compounds are known as on date, and few thousand newer are being discovered every month, every year as a result of ongoing research worldwide. In fact, total number of compounds of carbon that are known is much more than the all compounds known for remaining all other elements. So because of this large number of carbon compounds, we need a separate branch for the study of carbon and its compounds. Then the obvious question arises that what is so specific with this particular element carbon that it forms so large number of compounds? A basic idea of this question we have already known. We had studied in class 10th. But here it is only repetition to that. There are 4 or 5 major reasons that are responsible for this large number of carbon compounds. First is called tetravalency. Number 2, catenation. Third, capacity to form. Multiple bonds. And fourth is isomerism. So these are the 4 major points that are responsible for the large number of carbon compounds that are known. Let us try to understand them one by one. Tetravalency. As we know that carbon has got 4 electrons in its outermost shell. The structure of carbon can be understood like this. This first shell has got 2 electrons. Then in second shell, there are 4 electrons. So during chemical combination, there are 3 possible methods by which it could attain its duplet or its octet. First, it loses all these four electrons and it forms a C4 plus ion that will have two electrons in its outermost shell, or it accepts four electrons and forms a C4 minus ion in which outermost shell has got 8 electrons. And there is third possibility that it share 4 electrons from either 1 atom or from 2 atom or from 3 atom, depending on the condition, and forms bond. These two modes are the electrovalent mode of bonding, while the third one is the covalent mode of bonding. Now, under ordinary conditions, formation of a C4 plus ion or C4 minus ion is energetically not favored. The amount of energies that are required to fulfill this condition is actually not available. Hence, the possibility of formation of a C4 plus ion or C4 minus ion is ruled out, and the only way left for completion of octet of carbon is to share the electrons. And all the compounds of carbon are predominantly covalent in nature. That is, compounds are formed by sharing of electron between combining atoms. So, it has got 4 electrons in its outermost shell, and it easily share these 4 electrons to form different type of bonds. This refers to the tetravalency of carbon. Now we come to the next term, catenation. Catenation is the property, it is self-linking property. Catenation means self-linking property. Tendency or capacity of any element to combine with itself to form long chains. This tendency is highest in case of catenation. When a carbon-carbon single bond is formed, it is quite stable. Thereby, carbon has got very high tendency to combine with itself to form long chains. And it combines with itself to form this type of straight chain. Or this type of branched chains. Or rings. These are rings. So this is another reason why number of carbon compounds are very high. Chains starting from the 2 carbon to the 50 carbon, rings from 3 carbon to 50 carbon, all various type of possible reasons are various possibilities are known. Next is capacity to form in order to complete its octet, carbon not only forms multiple bonds with itself, but also forms multiple bonds with other elements of same period, or even in certain cases with other period elements also. Carbon is known to form multiple bonds with itself. In this way, carbon-carbon double bond, a carbon-carbon triple bond is known, a carbon-oxygen double bond is known, a carbon-nitrogen triple bond is known. Not only this, a carbon-sulfur double bond or carbon-phosphorus triple bonds are also known. So, in order to complete its octet, it not only forms single bond, but it also forms multiple bonds, that it also forms a double bond, it also forms a triple bond, not only with carbon itself, but it also forms multiple bonds with other elements like sulfur, like oxygen, nitrogen, phosphorus, etc. And this type of multiple bonding is not only formed in open chain compounds, but also it is observed in cyclic compounds. Further, isomerism. This is another important reason which is responsible for the large number of carbon compounds. In case of inorganic compounds, one molecular formula represents only one compound. Say for example, if I say that H2SO4, then this H2SO4 only represents one sulfuric acid. If you say HNO3, then it represents only one nitric acid. If you say KNO3, then it represents only one potassium nitrate. But in case of organic compounds, one molecular formula may represent more than one compounds. So compounds having same molecular formula but different structural formula and properties, different structural formula and properties are called isomers, and this phenomena is called as isomerism. For example, we take this example, CH3CH2OH and CH3OCH3. So its molecular formula is C2H6O, and here also molecular formula is C2H6O. So they have got same molecular formula, but if we look here, we can see that their structural formulae are different. Different sequence of atoms is there. Structural formula means what? Structural formula means the sequence in which different atoms that are present in that molecules, they are attached. So here oxygen is attached at one end to the carbon, on other end it is attached to the hydrogen. But in this oxygen atom is on both ends, it is attached to the carbon. So they have got different structural formula. And if we talk about properties, this is a liquid, this is a gas, this is non-poisonous, this is poisonous, this compound is an alcohol, while this compound is an ether. So apart from their molecular formula, Each and everything in these two compounds is different. Their structural formula is different and their properties are also different. So such compounds where molecular formula is same but their structural formula and properties are different, they are called isomers of each other, and this phenomena is termed as isomerism. This type of isomerism is not observed in general in case of inorganic compounds. Their one molecular formula only represents one particular product. But in case of organic compounds, one molecular formula may represent more than one compound or more than 10 compounds even. So this is another reason why number of carbon compounds are so high. So we was discussing that out of so many elements present in the periodic table, out of so many compounds elements present in the periodic table, why we have made a separate branch for the study of carbon and its compounds. Reason is very simple, that total number of compounds of carbon are very high. Number of carbon compounds are very large. Then obvious question arises that what is so specific with this carbon that number of carbon compounds are very high. Then there are many reasons to it which are not found with other elements, and their number of compounds are less. First is tetravalency. Carbon has 4 electrons in its outermost shell and it cannot enter by electrovalent mode of bonding. It cannot lose electrons or it cannot gain electrons because the energies that are required to do so are very high. So it largely go for covalent bonding. It share its 4 electrons which are present in its valence shell with single atom, with more than one atom, different type of atom, with the help of single bond, with the help of double bond, or a combination of single bond and double bond. That is what is termed as its tetravalency. Next point is catenation. The term catenation refers to the self-linking capacity of any atom. Its capacity to combine with itself to form long chains. Because of high stability of carbon-carbon single bond, catenation tendency is observed maximum in case of carbon. It very easily combines with itself to form long chains of carbon. It combines to make straight chains, to make branch chains, to make rings of varying length. Then its capacity to form multiple bonds. In order to complete its octet, carbon combines with itself. With the help of multiple bonds, it forms double bonds, it forms triple bonds with itself, and it also forms these double bonds and triple bonds with other elements of same period. Carbon is present in second period. So carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, these are the elements of same period which has got capacity to form multiple bonds. Carbon easily combined with these elements, with oxygen, with nitrogen, to form double bond and to form triple bonds. Not only this, carbon also forms multiple bonds with sulfur, phosphorus, etc. So this capacity of forming double bonds is also a reason for the large number of carbon compounds. And finally we come to this term, isomerism. The compounds having same molecular formula but different structural formula and properties are called isomers of each other. And this phenomena is known as isomerism. Iso means same, meros means forms. For example, this ethyl alcohol and dimethyl ether. Both of these compounds have got same molecular formula C2H6O, C2H6O. their molecular formula are same. But as far as their structural formula is concerned, it is quite different. And this difference in their structural formula gives rise to difference in their properties also. Ethyl alcohol is a liquid, is a non-poisonous substance, and is an alcohol. This belongs to a different class of chemical compounds that are called as alcohols. While this compound, dimethyl ether, is a gas, is poisonous, and comes in that under the a different class of organic compounds which are called as ethers. So these are the various factors that are responsible for large number of carbon and its compounds. And because of this large number and large variety of carbon compounds that are known, we need a separate branch for the study of carbon and its compounds. So I am quite sure that with this discussion you are able to understand that how organic chemistry has came in existence and why we need a separate branch for the study of carbon and its compounds. Now, as I told you that in organic compounds one molecular formula may represent more than one product, so during the course of study of organic chemistry, molecular formula are not used. In order to represent an organic molecule, we mainly use their structural formula. So in our next module, I will discuss classification of organic compounds and various conventions that are used to represent organic molecules during the study of organic chemistry. Till then, stay safe, stay home. Thank you. Bye-bye.